Alright guys, welcome to the video today. Got my wife Erin back joining us. So we're going to start a morning practice. Let's start standing up today in mountain pose. So wherever the front of your mat is, come to stand on it. So we're going to start in mountain pose position, hands down to the sides, really relaxed here. I want you to roll back the shoulders a few times, try to get them away from your ears. Relax your collarbones. Try to lift up the crown of your head, take a deep breath, and then just go ahead and pause. Set an intention for your practice today. Maybe bring the hands of your heart center and take a deep inhale through the nose. And deep exhale out. One more time, deep inhale through the nose. Deep exhale out. Very good, let's have a good practice today. Let's lower your arms down, inhale, reach them up over your head. Try to bring the hands together, look up a little bit, nice end. And then swan dive and forward fold down to the mat. On a breath in, look straight forward. And on a breath out, step back into plank pose. Do a low push up. So if you can do chaturanga, you'll bring your elbows into a bent position and lower down about halfway. And then work on tucking under your toes and lifting your back and chest up into cobra or urdhva vishvanasana pose. Hips up in the air to downward facing dog or adho vishvanasana. That's one round. When you get back into down dog, try to just neutral your breathing. We have about 5 breaths in this down dog. It's really nice. Try to press down the hands, press down the feet, and we're gonna inhale. 1. And inhale. 2. Inhale. 3. Inhale. Nice and deep and strong. Hold it. 4. And one more. Inhale. Come up on your tippy toes. Bend your knees. Look forward. Let's come up to the front of our mat. You can hop. Straighten your spine. Flatten your back out. Good. Push the hands against the knees, really strong here. Exhale, forward fold. As you begin to inhale, rise all the way up. Walk to stand. Use your core, reach back. And bring the hands down to the sides. Come back to mountain pose. Let's come back to that intention again. Hands to heart. Inhale, 1. Lift and reach your arms up in the air. Exhale, 2. Come into a forward fold position. Inhale, 3, straighten up your back. And exhale, 4, lower plank position. You can step back here. Again, go down to a low push-up. I want you to really squeeze your arms into the sides of your body. Look straight forward, nice. Tuck your toes, come up into cobra. On the breath in. Down dog, on your breath out. Good, great job. Inhale slowly and hold it. 1. 2. Really nice job pressing into your hands, pressing into your feet. Inhale. 3. Inhale. 4. And inhale. 5. Bend your knees. Look forward. Hop up to the front of your mat again. Straighten your spine out as you begin to inhale. Fold forward as you begin to exhale. Lift and reach your arms up as you inhale. Reach back. Good. Nice movement. Exhale. Arms down to the sides. Engage your core. And take a deep breath and find your center in the hands. together to the heart. Inhale, one position. Let's do that two more times. Lift your arms. Reach them up. Exhale, two position. Forward fold. Nice. Inhale, three position. Straighten out your spine. And exhale, four position. Low plank. You can step or you can hop back here if you like. Go down to a low push-up. Good job. Try to bend the elbows right when your feet are back. Inhale, cobra. And exhale, downward facing dog. One. So down dog becomes like a pose that we stay in for a little while after you start salutation. So you're working on lower body and upper body. Working on your breath work. Two. Inhale. Three. Inhale. Four. And one more time. Deeply inhale. Exhale. Five. Bend your knees. Look forward. Hop up to the front of your mat. Straighten your spine out. Right when you get there, right when your feet come to the front of your mat, try to look straight forward. Exhale, forward fold. Rise all the way up as you begin to breathe in. Reach back. Arms down to the sides. And hands come to heart for your deep inhalation. Let's do that one more round. Inhale, lift and reach your arms and hands up. Exhale, forward fold all the way down. Straighten your spine, and you're going to go right back into low plank here. Try to drop the arms. Bend the elbows right there. Yes. Very good. Try not to straighten the arms just yet. Yep. Your toes. And downward facing dog. There you go. We're going to take our first three-legged dog. So your right leg lifts on the breath in. Try to square that hip a little bit, yeah, and relax your right toes. Yeah, so you're looking at keeping this leg lifted but as straight as possible. Lift it up a little higher. Good. Three-legged dog. Make sure to press down into your right hand and left hand equally too. Really strong. Take one more deep breath. And now you can bend your knee and open up the right hand. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Straighten your right leg. Square your hips. Step your right foot between the hands. Let's come into a warrior one. Spin the left heel down. Lift and reach your arms over your head. Good. So you have that front foot really strong here. You're pressing down into the right side. Twerking that left hip forward just a bit here. You can open up the legs a little bit wider if you can here. Maybe bring that left foot out to the left side a little bit more. Out to the left side, not back. To your left. Left foot to your left side. Okay, then take your hands, open them out to your warrior two. Take your right hand up, come to a peaceful warrior. Really dive all the way back. Then that nice stretch in the right side. Keep the right arm active and stretched. Take your hands, cartwheel them down all the way to dog pose. Right foot steps back. Breathe in. Downward facing. Breathe out. Lower plank position. Let's roll forward. Bend your arms. Try to hover. And tuck your toes. Take it into cobra. On the inhale. Down dog. On the exhale. One big breath here, then we'll do the next side. Inhale. Exhale. Lift your left leg as you inhale. We first want to drive that neutral hip position. So that's our strength-based three-legged dog. When we open up that hip a little bit, it's more of like our flexibility version of it. So work on the strengthening aspect first. Keeping the hips squared. Nice. Flex that foot and toes down too, so your heel should be pushing back. Maybe you can lift it up a little bit higher. Nice job. Make sure you're breathing down into that right leg as well too. Let's take one more deep breath. Inhale, and then open up the left leg. Exhale. Really bending your left knee, opening it up. In. Breathe out. In. Straighten your left leg out. Bring your left foot between the hands. Straighten your leg. Step it between the hands. Warrior one pose. Spin your right heel down. Lift. Let's go ahead and reach your arms overhead. Warrior one. Now sometimes I like the feet out a little bit wider, so it gives you more room to play around with bringing that back hip in a little bit. There's so many different versions of the warrior poses. There's even ones where you bring your hands together, and that's one way to change it up a little bit here. But we're just going to take the arms, the hands, and open them up from warrior one to a warrior two. Okay. And then from a warrior two, bring it out to a peaceful warrior. Left arm up and back. There's a front leg here, strong here. You want your arms to be along as well. And we'll go all the way down to dog pose. Breathe out. Plank pose. Breathe in. Make sure you go back to down dog. Yep, then roll forward, plank. Lower push up. Exhale, high cobra, inhale, downward facing, exhale. One big breath here, breathe in, breathe out. Let that breath move smoothly. Bend your knees, look forward, or hop up to the front of your mat. Right when you get there, just try to straighten out your back, look straight forward. As you exhale, fold forward. Let's bend your knees, lift it up into a chair pose position. So you guys know weight, more back on the heels is going to be much better for stretching and getting into your hips. Another version of this is coming up on the toes and sweeping your arms back. So come into spears position, nice. Really focus here on just trying to find your balance, your focus. Stay sharp. Inhale. Exhale. You can come back to chair now. Good. Get back on the heels, arms up. Stand all the way up. Bring your hands together. Good. Pick it up. You can relax your arms. So let's do a sun V here. Come back to chair pose. Bend your knees. Squat down. Breathe in. One breath here. Breathe out. Forward fold position. Stretch your legs. Inhale. Straighten your back. Take a vinyasa flow. Step or jump your feet. Low cobra, high cobra. Inhale. Exhale, downward facing. Right leg lifts. Breathe in. stab it between the hands, breathe out. Warrior one pose. Breathe in. And we're gonna go to warrior two pose. Breathe out. Peaceful warrior, breathe in. We're trying to bend the right knee. Stretch out. Downward facing dog, breathe out. And take a flow. With a plank, low push-up, high cobra, breathe in, down dog, breathe out, left leg up, breathe in, hold it, step it forward between the hands, warrior one, breathe in, warrior two, breathe out. Peaceful warrior. Don't reach back. And just drive through that left hand. Let's go again one more time. Back to downward facing dog. Step. Breathe out. Breathe in here. Come into plank. Breathe out. Lower. Breathe in. Cobra. Breathe all the way in. Breathe out. Downward facing dog. You should feel a little warmer. It's our yoga warrior flow. We have that one more time. Bend your knees. Step, jump, or hop your way up to the front of the mat. Straighten your spine. Forward fold. Come all the way up. Keep the arms lifted. Bend your knees. Go right down into a chair pose. Squat. Great abdominal exercise here. Great way to strengthen your midsection, strengthen your core. One breath here. Forward fold down. Breathe out. Breathe in. Straighten your back. Breathe out. Step or hop your feet back. Go to a low push-up. High cobra. Downward dog. Lift your right leg. Step it forward, warrior one. Breathe in, lift your arms, raise them up. Come on. Breathe out, warrior two. Breathe in, go to peaceful warrior. Breathe out, downward facing dog. Step back. Plank pose. Come on, you got this. One more side to do. Tuck your toes. Bend your elbows. Cobra. Breathe in. Down dog. Breathe out. Bend the left leg. Breathe in. Step it forward. Warrior one. Great job. Inhale right there. Open up to warrior two. Breathe out. Warrior, breathe in. Downward facing dog. Breathe out. Step back. Shift forward a plank on the breath in. Come on, this is our last one, y'all. Over now. Breathe in, cobra. Breathe out, downward facing dog. Really deep breath here. Hold it. Try to sip in a little bit more. Hold it. And let it out. Drop your knees. Take a tabletop pose. Sit back into your child pose. Really nice warrior flow today. So rest here your forehead. Rest your hips. You really want to notice every breath, the way that you're breathing, how you're breathing. Come up into tabletop pose. Breathe in. The tabletop pose starts to go through a couple of cats and cows. Hope you guys can hear me this time. So, breathe out, cat pose. Breathe in, cat lift. And breathe out. cat pose. Breathe in, cat lift. Breathe out, move the cat, round your back, round your spine. And breathe in, open up, cat lift position. Stretch your hands up to the corners of your mat. Put puppy's pose. You can slide your knees back a little bit. Yeah, stretch. A little bit more of the lower back to middle back to the upper back here. Let's stretch. Take a deep breath. And slide all the way forward into sphinx position. We'll lay down on the elbow. And toes should be tucked under this way. Maybe one way that's more comfortable for you, where you're pressing down to the toes, you're pressing down into your leg. The more that you hold the pose, the more you're gonna feel a lot of release around the shoulders and from the neck. Open your arms out a little bit wider, your elbows, your hands out. Relax your hands, relax your jaw. And just try to hold, keep breathing. Let your inhales just be, and let your exhales just be. Perfect weather for yoga, right? So hold that sphinx pose, bring the elbows right under the shoulder, in the middle a little bit more. And here you go, you're gonna turn from a sphinx position up into a wide arms cobra. A wide arm, a wide hand, coming up a little bit. Feel free to get those hands a little bit off the mat. Good, nice job. Getting that backward bend. And exhale, lower down to the mat. Let's do that one more time. Press into the fingertips. So you're working on the grip strength, working on fingertip strength. Inhale, come up. Wide arms, cobra. Breathe out. Come on down. Relax. Press into your tabletop position. And press back into your child's pose. And breathe out. Inhale, tabletop. Go down on the forearms one more time. We're going to step back into a forearm plank. We'll work a little bit of core. So go between a forearm plank to a dolphin. Or you just lift your hips up. Great way to engage the core. Also take weight off of your wrists. This is great for the shoulder blades and all that space all the way around the upper part of your back that goes down from the neck. Such a great way to open up some of these parts of your body. Lock your toes in a little bit. Come up on the tippy toes. Feeling a little bit more in the legs, you should hear. Relax the heels. I'm relaxing it. Now take a deep breath and just work on trying to stretch out the back of the legs. Stretch your hamstrings. Good. Deep inhale here. Deep exhale. One more time, deep inhale here. deep exhale. Do a nice governor. Take it down. Lower the knees, sit back into your child pose. We're going to work on a fun posture here, yoga headstand. Aaron has a really great practice of going in a headstand. Hopefully we'll walk through it and we'll go through it. Are you ready?
Sure.
Come off the table. And grab your elbows. Come down the elbows. Grab the elbows. So this is your measuring stick. Just to kind of keep the shoulders and elbows more or less in this distance. They're not permanently stuck there, but you want them more or less to be about the width of your shoulders, be about the width of your elbows, your body. So right here, what I like to do is loosen up the neck. Just loosen up the neck. Make sure you move it around a little bit. In yoga headstand, you're not dumping a lot of weight into the neck by putting your head down. Now we're going to take your hands and interlace them together. Now you're going to cup the very top edge of, or the top part of your head down to the mat. Relax that neck, keep it long. Cup your toes, lift your knees, and start to walk your feet forward. This is the part of yoga headstand that I love just getting into and practicing. This takes a lot of effort to get into and hold it. But if you're ready to move to the next part, take one of your legs, bend it, lift it up, and then try to bring that other opposite leg to meet it, while at the same time you're moving your hips above your body. Awesome. Great control. Try out your yoga headstand, maybe with a wall, maybe by staying in that first part. But it's a great pose to work out a little bit. To build strength, to look at things in a different perspective sometimes. That's important. Take a deep breath here. Hold the star as long as you can. It's all you. Straight down to your child's pose. Relax. Relax deeply. Your forehead. Your hips. Straighten up into your tabletop pose. Then cross your legs, head into a seat position. We want to stretch the legs out here for this next one. So go ahead, stretch your legs, stretch out your feet. On the next breath in, raise your arms over your head. On the next breath out, stretch forward and reach your hands towards your feet. Into a little bit of a back bend. Bring your hands back. feel free to get into that neck and shoulder space. Then slide up to the front of your mat. Lay down on your back. And hug your knees into your chest. Start to massage the whole part of your back. So focus a little bit on the hips now. Cross your right ankle over your left knee for the chicken pose. You want this knee to move forward. And if you can try, left knee lifts up. Back is relaxed here, your neck relaxed. Take a deep breath. Switch your legs. Bring the right foot down, the left foot down. And lift the left leg over the right. Left knee forward as much as you can. Focusing in just in that hip region. You want your back just to be as comfortable as you can. Last deep breath. Let it go. Release. Bring your knees into your body. Massage your back a little. Lower your feet down into bridge pose. As you breathe in, your hips are going to lift up. Very nice. And as you breathe out, you can slowly release your hips down. Grab your knees. Lower them all the way down to your right side. Once the knees are down, just relax. Make sure you're breathing and you continue to breathe into your twist. We'll lift the knees and change them back to the other side. Okay, just relax a little bit. Back to center. Make sure to grab the knees here, hug them really tight. You can invert legs up here if you want to take happy baby pose, or maybe even just trying to get those feet over your head. Let the blood flow from your feet drain down to your legs and go towards your body. Go more in towards your upper body, towards your heart. Next part of our practice is our relaxation. Move on slowly and make sure you take the time now to deeply relax. Let the legs go. Let the arms go. Nice. Find your final relaxation. Slowly, when you're ready, lift your arms and take a deep breath. Gently come back to this moment that we're in. Gently come back to your body. Bend your knees. Roll and turn out to the side. And we'll seal our practice. Nice, comfortable, easy seat. Thank you guys so much for joining. Thank you. And namaste.